And Francis Rossi and Rick Parfitt have formed the backbone of Status Quo for almost four decades, recording an impressive 31 albums. But behind the music, the pair confess they've hidden much of the truth about their real stories.
Well, in a new book about their lives, they talk about the excesses of the music industry, as well as life in one of the most successful British bands in history. We'll be hearing from the pair in just a moment or two, but first let's take a look at some of the highlights of their quite remarkable careers in Status Quo. Rick Parfitt and Francis Rossi are with us now. Welcome.
Good morning
to both of you. So where do we start? I mean, this, you've had such a long career, but this is the book that tells us the truth about what really happened, is it, Rick?
Well, really, yeah. I mean, we've tried to be as honest as possible. And a lot of people have said to us that it's quite unbelievable how honest we've been in it. But, I mean, you know, I think the book does give you an insight, if you like, and a warning, if you like, that... What living life to excess can do to you.
Well, could you remember it all then, Francis, given the excesses?
We forgot a lot of the 80s, didn't we? It was the 80s that kind of disappeared. See, it's forgotten. But it's the thing everyone was doing then, and we kind of followed suit. We started with about 30 getting out of control and got really out of control.
And what then changed? Was it just age that made you just think, oh,
what's
can't
that?
Quite?
What's age? Probably. That, I don't know. We like to think you grow up a bit, I suppose, but I mean, some people do that. You know, at the weekend, we did it all the time.
Also physically, I mean, you know, you start to feel it. And if you want to, you know, maintain the band and the good performances, because we perform for the best part of 2 hours now, and you've got to look after yourself as you get a bit older.
Well, in all honesty, it nearly killed you, Rick, didn't it? I mean, you made it almost, your heart bypass surgery. I mean, was that due to the excess, the strain of the touring?
I suppose, yeah. I mean, you know, it had a lot to do with it, I would think, but... At one stage, they told me if I didn't have the operation, I had 24 hours to live. So, do it.
But it's interesting that you know you really keep up that pace today, and you still do a huge number of live performances every year. How many is it that you?
We were 115 last year, and I think it's 110 this year. We're taking it easy.
I mean, even with however well you look after yourself, I mean, it's a heck of a pace to sustain.
But there is something in it's. We're insecure little show-offs, really. I think anybody in show business is. We have to go on stage to get that gratification, otherwise you're just these two blokes. And you just
it's
love
also,
that thing.
I think what we do, isn't it? I mean, we've done it for such a long time. Mm. You asked me to run a mile, I couldn't. But you go on stage and jump, skip, you know, play, sing for 2 hours. It's
exercise. It's saves you going to the gym.
It's doing a workout, yeah, it really is, yeah.
Now listen, I know along with the autobiography, you've got a new album out, the Greatest Hits, but there's also some new songs on it, aren't there?
There's two new songs on there.
Two new songs. So kind of more orchestral feel or something?
Yeah. More of an orchestral feel, as you were saying.
Of course. Status Quo, more.
Yeah. It's called You'll Come Round, isn't it?
That's one of them.
Quo today, do you find that you're attracting a new generation of fans, or do you think the fans are the ones who've stayed with you all those years?
A bit of both, yeah. It really is, yeah. I mean, it's anything from 8 to 80 now, and it's a great sight from the stage to see everybody up and having a good time, you know. And I think there are still a lot of fans around from...
Yeah, something. From, but I think we really picked up some younger people in the last 5 or 6 years, thanks to a lot of those bands that mime, so we can thank them for that. I really do think a lot of people have got fed up listening to... mimed music. There's something about live music. You think it can go wrong, or you feel it can go wrong,
and we do. It does sometimes.
And so it's, you know, it's real.
Yeah. I just wonder what the challenges are then. Now, you know, looking through the statistics and facts and figures about Quo, 100 appearances, more than 100 appearances on Top of the Pops. Of course, your huge role in Live Aid. It could go on. Had more hit albums in the British chart than any other band apart from the Rolling Stones. I mean, where do you go from here? What are the challenges?
Well, I mean, you know, we've always been known as a working band, and the rest of this year we'll be gigging. Next year's going to be very busy because it's the 40th anniversary, so we're going to go to all the places throughout the world that we know and like. And I don't know, it's just something, you know, I don't know, personally, I don't know what I'd do without quo. It's been all my life. You know,
but can you, Francis, at some point sort of see yourself sort of thinking, you know, retirement might be quite nice?
At the moment, it really feels great. The idea of retirement. When I was running up the road trying to beat the car to get here because we were late. But we're talking about taking, I keep saying 86, it's not 86, it's 2006. we might take 2006 off or slow down a bit that year, but I dare say we'll start again in 07.
So. Slow down to 50 or 60 gigs
yeah.
that year.
Yeah.
But that's slow a shame,
things.
Really.
Yeah. I just like the fact you never forget your roots, because it was 25th anniversary, wasn't it, which is quite a long time ago now. You did it at Butlins or something.
Well, that's where we met in 65. Francis was in a rock band and I was doing cabaret. And we kind of met and just became pals immediately. And it's kind of been that way ever since.
The rest is history.
Yeah, as they say.
Thank you very much to both of you, Rick Francis.
Looking forward to the 50th anniversary.
You'll be there, mate.
Yeah.
After,
in my wheelchair. Right, thank you.